So welcome to module 3.1, and in this module we will be talking about sequential logic. So what I have been talking so far, we have been talking so far about something called combinational logic. So what is combinational logic? The output of the circuit depends upon the current combination of the inputs. So we have seen adder, we have seen multiplexer, let us say multiplexer. So there is a select input 0, 1, A, B. So the current value of the output depends upon the combination of the inputs. Like for example, select is 0 and A is 1, output is 1. Whatever B be, B can be anything, but since select is 0, out is 1. So what is, how is out determined? By the current combination of values of the inputs. That is why we call it as a combinational circuit. Now, the point with combinational circuit is it cannot remember anything of what happened before. Currently, what is the input? It will just, that combination of inputs, it will take and give you an output. It does not have the capacity to remember something that happened, say, before this step or sometime earlier in this. So that is why this is called a combinational logic. So essentially, the combinational logic does not have any memory. But the systems that we are trying to build needs memory. That is, we need to remember what happened just at least just before what the previous type. Let us take one example of why this memory is needed, right. So before we go into that, sequential logic is set of circuits which can remember data, remember the content or whatever you call. I can remember it, whatever was there in the previous cycle or previous instance, I can basically remember it in this instance. So this is basically what we call as the sequential logic. Now sequential logic is needed for building any system, because system is actually the system, the compute systems that we are seeing are basically state based. State is nothing but the values of the different elements in the just before, right. At any point of time, the value of the elements form the of the particular circuit forms the state of the circuit. Now I need to remember the previous state for me to calculate the next state. So we will take some examples in this direction where state becomes very simple examples where state becomes important. Let us see, let us take the digital watch that you have. So what does the digital watch do? It basically starts with 0 hours, then it goes on till 00 59 seconds, then it becomes 01 and so on. So this will go on till 059, then 01. This will go on till 01, 59, 59, then it will become 02. Like this, it will go back to this. Right. So this is an example of a digital watch. To actually make a working digital watch, what I need to do? For deriving next state, I need to know the previous state. Right. And that is very, very important. If I do not know the previous state, then I cannot basically do this digital watch. So, like let us take this example, 00, 01, 00 comes because in the previous state I had 00, 00, 59. 00, 01, 00 will not follow anything other than 00, 00, 59. So, I need to remember this state to derive this state. I need to remember this state to derive what we call as 00, 01, 01 and so on and so forth. Okay. So, I need to know the so this is a very simple example where I need to know the previous state for me to progress to the next state. So, that means the previous state has to be stored in some value and that will be used. So, let me say that each one is a step. Sometimes you can call it as a cycle, each one is a cycle. So, in the first cycle, I will have 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. In the next cycle, I will have 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1. Like that, it will become 0, 0, 0, 0, 6, 0. Then, sorry, 0, 0, 0, 0, 5, 9. Then, it will become 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, and so on, so forth. Okay? Right? So, I need to remember three things: the second, the minute, the hour. And this goes through a logic through which it is fed, and the output goes here, and the output is fetched back. So, I store the second, minute, and hour, and that is given as an input to the logic, right? And that gives an output, and it gives the next state here. So, I will have a clock. This is called a clock. So, what will the clock do? Every time it will advance. So, initially the values will be 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. This will be input to this logic. This logic will generate 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, and it will generate 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1 on this line. Right. So, this will feed this logic and the logic will feed the external world, while it will also try to come and try to set this to the next stage. So, this 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1 will be here, and when will this 0, so these two are same, previous state and current state, when will 0, 1 enter here? When the clock is given next. So, every clock pulse, you say clock is, there is some external clock, every clock pulse, this value will keep changing. So, it will change from 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0 to 0, 0, 0, 0, 5, 9, then after that it has to become 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0. So, there is some logic which will take the previous state and compute what should be the next state. This is basically a combinational logic or combo logic. So, this is how a sequential machine is formed. So, a general form of a sequential machine, this is called Huffman's model of sequential machine. In the Huffman's model of sequential machine, what do you have? You basically have a combinational circuit, then you have the flip-flops or whatever memory, we will call it memory. This is the output. This is the input. This is a generic Huffman's model of a sequential circuit. So, I have a combinational block. I have some memory here. So, and then I have a clock here. So, we start with 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, that is fed here. There is no external input here as for this circuit is concerned for the clock, there is no external input. So, it immediately came back as 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1 and it was waiting here. So, the next clock pulse it became 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1 and that is fed here. It comes as 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 2, 2, 3, 3, 4, 4, 5, etcetera. It just keeps rotating here. So, this is how the clock basically, the wall clock that we saw or the digital clock we saw, this is how we work. Necessarily, when I want to make a digital system, I need to have a combinational block and a small memory or scratch pad, which will be storing the previous state of the circuit. So any circuit which has these memory components or memory cells inside, those circuits are called sequential circuits, right. So, we will see more on the sequential circuit in the next module. Thank you.